KCP is a stock on our radar, and the street is a bit disappointed by the quarter-on-quarter margin contraction. GN Murty, the CFO of the company, joins in on the phone line to discuss more details. Mr. Murty, first, if you could explain what led to the sequential fall at your operating profit level, and what can you guide for FY18 on your revenues and margins now?
Good morning. The KCP Limited performed better in the quarter four of the current year compared to the last year quarter. On the year-on-year basis, yes, there is a reduction. Mainly contributed by, the reduction is contributed by the new segment, hotel, and also there are little more losses in the engineering industry. Cement industry has done better than last year.
All right. Hi, Mr. Murty. Good to see you and thanks so much for joining in. Sir, in terms of your cement business, that's from where bulk of your revenues come in. So could you give us the sales volumes number for your fourth quarter with a comparable number? And also in FY17, how much cement have you sold?
Yeah. In Q4, we sold about 4.9 lakh tons against 4.3 lakh tons of the last year Q4. And in year 17, we sold about 17.5 lakh tons against 15.3 lakh tons in the last year. There's an improvement of about 15% in the volume, and there is an improvement on EBITDA level at about 12% in Q4, and overall in the year, there is an improvement of 5% in EBITDA level in the cement segment.
So you have clocked in a 15% sales volume growth in FY17. What is the expected volume growth in FY18, considering your cement capacity is likely to also go up, of course, a year later, but for FY18 as well as FY19, if you could give us a sense of what you're targeting by way of a volume growth.
The volumes as it is are on very high level now in the current year. There are about 17.5 lakh tons. We are targeting first to meet this target, the higher base, and a marginal increase would be there in the current next year, FY18. And FY19, we are going to get additional capacity of 1.5 million tons. We are going to get at least additional 1 million in FY19 on full year basis, but the capacity addition would be in the middle of the year. Proportionately, it would be about 500,000 tons in FY19 extra.
Okay, so flattish for FY18?
FY18 more or less flattish.
Okay.
All right. Ms. Murthy, we're talking about your cement business. So I just want a couple of more details. What was the EBITDA per ton for FY17? If you could help us out with the cement EBITDA per ton. And also, Mr. Murthy, just let me interrupt you. There's been a price correction, I believe, in the month of May from the highs that we saw in April. What is the total quantum of the price cut?
On the EBITDA per ton of cement is about 800 rupees in the current year, that is FY17. Last year, on full year basis, it was about 880. There is a reduction of about 80 rupees per ton of cement on EBITDA level.
Okay. Mr. Murthy, let me come to your new businesses, hotels and engineering, which dragged at the operating level in Q4. What is the outlook looking like in FY18? Do you think for your engineering business, it will be a degrowth next year as well? And on hotels, what are you guiding?
In fact, engineering industry is now growing with the Make in India concept and all that. We are likely to have better results in the next year. We are targeting a turnover of about 100 crores, between 90 and 100 crores. We are expecting it to be better. On the hotel, there is a consistent regular increase in the occupancy levels and other revenues in the hotel. From 20% occupancy level, we have gone up to 45% towards the end of the year, in the last quarter. And next year, we are expecting about 55% occupancy levels. We are hoping that we would break even at EBITDA level in the hotel in the FY18. And on the prices of cement in FY18, so far, there is a reduction of about 10% prices in the Andhra Pradesh.
That's on cement prices?
Yeah.
10% reduction in the month of May itself?
Correct.
Is it because, sir, there is some political pressure? We hear that the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh, of Telangana, they've been putting some pressure in terms of prices. Have you got any kind of communication coming in from there? That's why you'll have reduced prices by 10%?
I cannot comment on this political pressure. But there is a reduction. There are news that the government insists that lower prices should be maintained.
Oh, all right. So that could impact your performance and going ahead, sir?
It would not impact straight away by 10%. Because there would be reductions on excise and sale taxes correspondingly.
All right.
Mr. Murty, it's quite a diversified business right now. Things are improving for engineering as well as hotel. Hotel, you're targeting to be EBITDA break-even next year. For engineering as well, you're targeting revenues of close to about, 100-odd crore. Any plans to demerge your business and just focus on your core cement and perhaps the Vietnamese sugar business?
Our core strength is engineering and cement.
Okay.
And in Vietnam sugar. And we do not have any plans to demerge our new initiative of hotel. We do not have right now any plans.
All right. So, Mr. Murty, you were saying that maybe you could break even in the hotel business. Do you think that's even possible? Because, currently it's really dragging your operational performance. And the second part of the question, Mr. Murty, will you look to sell any of these businesses? Your investors will be very happy if we get the core cement, we get, engineering, you're saying, is quite important. And also, Vietnamese sugar business. Will there be any plans to sell any of these businesses that are dragging the operational performance?
No, in fact, the hotel industry dragged the performance at EBITDA level by only 2 crores. It's only the depreciation and interest which have dragged down in the hotel. So right now, we do not have any plans of demerging any segment.
And don't decide.
But down the line, maybe 3-4 years later, probably we'll look at it.
Okay. What about the debt on your books and any plans to bring it down in FY18?
No, in fact, since we are expanding our capacity, our debt will be increasing even after considering the repayment of the old debt. Our current debt is about 330 crores compared to 347 crores of last year. We have repaid and also drawn for our expansion. So net effect is reduction now. We are running at a lower, debt equity ratio of lower than 1%, 1:1. We are at 0.8 debt. So there would be little drawal for the expansion. And there would be a marginal increase by about 10-15% in the overall debt.
Mr. Murty, final question before you go. Do you have any surplus land? You know why? Because I'm a little worried. Suppose you'll decide to set up another hotel or you have some other plans to diversify into any other businesses. So do you have surplus land? Do you plan on any further diversification?
No, we are not planning for any diversification anywhere.
All right, Mr. Murty. Thanks so much, sir, for joining in and giving us all those details. So that, in fact, is a management.